I be rolling with the squad, we be going so hard like, whoa. You know what it is, and we always get in it, whoa.
Alright, we're gonna try Kallari again. I've got a kind of a laning deck for him. And people are probably gonna think I'm crazy because I'm laning with him, but it's actually the build that I've got's not bad. It's not complete, but it's not bad either, so we'll see how this works out. Hopefully it's not too bad. I've had some good games, had some bad games. I had, I think my best game with him was 12 and 4. 12, 4, and 9. I had one, two games ago. I had 9 and, I was 9 and 2. I don't remember how many assists I had, but I was 9 and 2. My last game, I was 5-5, I think, with 2 assists. I played that with Jeebs. I'm going to be uploading that as well. It'll probably be uploaded before this video, so all depends on how well I do with this one. That'll determine which video goes up first. It'll kind of set my priorities. But, yeah, we're going to try and, try and get more than 5 kills this match. Not saying that I will, but I'm gonna try. Goal is to get as many as possible. My actual goal is to get at least 5. If I can get at least 5, I'll be good. Alright. Main Kallari, confirm. And first thing we're gonna get is the crippling dagger.
Minions are spawning.
So mostly what I focus on with Kallari is getting his basic attack up, because when you go invisible, your next attack does more damage as you level up your invisibility anyway. But your ult is all based on your base attack damage anyway. It zips in, does one basic attack, so the higher your basic attack is, the more of an asset your alt is going to be. A lot of people are going to call you out for KSing and blah blah blah. That's how Kallari is built. She is meant to be an assassin, so don't worry about that at all. Kills are kills. I know kill stealing is not always the most awesome way to go, but it works. So after I kill those first two minions, I usually pop my health potion here and just stand here and just go toe-to-toe with him. Use Crippling Dagger whenever it is available. But you are regaining more health than he is dealing. So, and by the time you're done regenerating health, he's low enough that you're not going to have to worry about popping your potion again. There you go, your team just got red buff. So next we're gonna get the invisibility, and we're going to see who needs some help. Because our harvesters are, the wells are still offline, so getting harvesters, trying to plant harvesters isn't gonna do a whole lot.
An enemy has been slain.
Thank you. See if we can get back. We got some card power. We did some damage. You're not really gonna get very many kills right off the bat, so don't worry too much about that.
Enemy tower destroyed. An allied tower is under attack.
If you're not getting kills right off the bat, like I said, don't worry about it. You're not going to. That'll come later as we start getting more stuff, more equipment. Also, your crippling dagger is good for last hitting minions. It does use a little bit of mana, but it's not too bad. Durable than we are at this point. So we're gonna go back and try to grab some more stuff. So what I actually was aiming for was my other Wind Carver blade. But I got this one instead, so I'll run with it. But my other Wind Carver blade actually has the kinetics, which make you your basic attacks refresh, so you can use them faster and more frequently. Destroyed. But I grabbed the wrong one, so we'll just level this one up first. Oh shit, we're gonna die. Okay, we did die. Which I knew we were going to with a blue Gideon. Gideon is cheap. So, I was pretty much expecting that at this point. Alright, we're gonna go for what we should have been doing a lot earlier. That's gonna be placing harvesters. You're going to get behind your teammates, don't worry about it. That's pretty much how you're going to be with Kallari, but you are still going to be doing massive damage by the time we're done. So don't worry about getting a little bit behind the rest of your teammates. Doesn't matter at this point in the game. It's not going to matter a little later in the game either, it's just not really going to matter at all. Here, we'll help him out. Woo-hoo. Ah, fuck. Still got hit by it. Might have been a waste warping in there, but that's all right.
An enemy tower is under attack.
Just to warn you guys, there's gonna be a baby crying. Always is around this time of night. It's my sister's kid, and you can probably already hear it. Just a warning.
Enemy tower is under attack. Enemy tower destroyed.
How did I miss? Fuck me! Fuck, that was bullshit. Somebody else has been grabbing my card experience.
Allied tower is under attack. An allied tower is under attack.
Yep, you've said that 9 times now. Got him. Ah, he stole my Gideon. Ah, he stole my gadget too, are you kidding me? No, I had a double kill. I'm gonna go back. Grab some stuff. Bye-bye. Looks like one of ours is about to get gone too. Not gonna want to go one-on-one with me. I can tell her that right now. Okay, smart woman. She backed off.
An allied tower is
You're welcome. She's dead.
Dominating.
Get him. Nice job. Alright. Get him. Get him, get him, get him, get him, get him, get him. No, you're gonna lose him. See if we can get out here and get a couple more kills going real quick. Some of these guys out a little bit, but I highly doubt it. Looks like they're doing just fine on their own. He's probably gonna be dead by the time I get there. cut him. Blue gadget, I don't think we're going to get up there very quickly anyway. We may still be able to take her out. Not banking on it though. Bye-bye. Ah, I was so close.
The enemy core is under attack. Enemy has been executed.
Doing decent on this one. Not great. I mean, we're 8-2, which is not bad. But it's definitely not awesome. Fuck, I'm gonna die. Oh! Whew. Got her!
Mega streak.
That is why we level up our basic attack, so we can pull off shit like that. Alright, let's see, what else do we have? Another major strike. Look at that, we've got the most kills on the team. And the highest amount of card experience, so. Like I said, Lane Kallari works. You just have to have the right deck for it. Now, we're not gonna be able to. Ooh. We're not going to be able to warp again because... or teleport or whatever you want to call it.
Enemy inhibitor is under siege.
See, we're 12, 2, and 5. We're doing pretty damn good. Let's get this inhibitor out of here. Spent points. All right. Nice.
Massacre.
Like I said at the beginning of this, you're gonna get a few kill steals. That's how Kallari is played, and also since you are leveling up far slower than the rest of your teammates, you're going to need to team kill in order to keep up, but it's not necessarily bad. KSing in this isn't quite as bad as it used to be, like in other games. Whew. Such as League of Legends. Oh shit. I knew that was coming. Oh shit, that was bad charging in there. I should have known better. We're not doing bad though. 12 and 3, that's pretty good. I mean, yeah, I've had better games. But actually no. Really I haven't. I've had more assists. I've had a 12, 4, and 9. But like I said that at the beginning of the video. But I don't really care so much about assists. I'm more about the kills and deaths. So right now, this is actually, as far as my KD ratio, this is the best game I've had. So it's going to be a little bit of a longer video, obviously. The core is still at 68%, so there's still some time. I don't really care about going for the core. I go more for enemy kills. So there's still a little bit of time to get some more of those. And right now our base attack is up high enough that it's very feasible that we get more kills. Nice job.
The enemy core is under attack.
Hey. Hey, you. Hey. Hey. Over here. We're gonna win this one. Bye-bye. There we go. Level 15. We're max level.
The enemy core is under attack.
Not to die while we're killing it. There we go. Nice job. Nice job. There we go. 14, 3, and 5. So, like I said, Lane Kallari does work. So, thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Ciao!